Dan Mullen, WTNR News, brought to you this hour by Wayne County Furniture.
Senator Albert Gore has joined us in the studio now. We'll talk with him in just a moment. Senator Gore, welcome to WTNR and to Waynesboro.
Thank you. I, as a child, I memorized every single word of that song you were just playing.
Did you have a coonskin cap to go with it?
I sure did.
Well, would you tell us what happened over at your meeting in the courthouse here in Waynesboro?
We had a great discussion about a number of issues. I spend my time here in meetings at the grassroots level instead of talking with the lobbyists and special interest groups, because that's the way democracy is supposed to work. I represent the people of Wayne County in Washington in the United States Senate, and that's why I come to talk with whoever shows up to discuss the issues. And we really had a good discussion today, and I'll be back for other open meetings on a regular basis.
Well, that's good. We're happy to have you here at these meetings, and it's a good opportunity for the public. I know you have a busy schedule and other places to go to, and we thank you for coming by, WTN.
Well, thank you very much. I'm on my way to Hardin County a little bit later and working real hard, and I want to invite your audience anytime there's a problem we can help with, or anytime you have an opinion to express. I'm anxious to learn how I can do the best job possible of representing you in the United States Senate. Just address it to Senator Al Gore, Washington, D.C., and it'll get to me. Thanks for having me on today.
Thank you.
Together now, baby.
Games. Collinwood beat Huntland 18-14. Lewis County beat Wayne County 40-0. Next Friday, it's Wayne County at Spring Hill and Collinwood at Mount Pleasant. An advanced word perfect course will start Monday, October 12th at Wayne County High School evening classes. The classes will meet each Monday for 5 weeks, 6 p.m. till 8:50 each Monday. The first class is October 12th. Students may register on that night. The fee is $40 plus $5 registration. Ava Barnett is the instructor. Further information is at Columbia State, 388-0120, extension 290. The 1992 Tennessee Hay Directory is available from the Tennessee Department of Agriculture, Division of Marketing. The annual directory provides buyers with statewide information about Tennessee hay. This year's directory lists hay producers from more than 30 counties across Tennessee. According to Agricultural Commissioner L.H. Cotton-Ivey, a better-than-normal fall harvest has offset spring's undesirable harvest and curing conditions. Excellent moisture amounts throughout the summer are responsible for the abundant fall hay crop. For your free copy, call 800-342-8206. Dan Mullen, WTNR News, brought to you this hour by Wayne County Furniture. This Thursday at noon is the deadline to qualify as a candidate for the Clifton Commission. In the general election in November, the city of Clifton will elect commissioners to the seats occupied now by Tony Ricketts and Virgil Ray. To qualify as an official candidate on the November ballot, nominees must pick up the official nominating petition form from the election office at the Wayne County Courthouse and turn it into the courthouse by noon this Thursday, August 20th. Candidates must reside in the city of Clifton. Once again, the deadline to qualify as a candidate for Clifton Commissioner is noon Thursday, August 20th. At least 25 registered voter signatures are required on the petition. Wayne County schools have registration the morning of Thursday, August 27th. The first full day for all Wayne County schools is Monday, August 31st. The Tennessee Wildlife Resources Agency announces that squirrel season will open this Saturday, August 22nd in Tennessee, marking the start of a long 1992-93 hunting season. The bag limit will be 10 squirrels per day, the same limit as last year. The Tennessee Hunting and Trapping Guide lists legal hunting equipment for squirrels. The season ends January 31st.
Ace is a place for all sorts of great stuff. So, hey, listen to this.
Look at those beautiful Christmas trees at Waynesboro Ace Hardware, starting at only $9.99. Boys and girls 20-inch bikes are on sale, too. Ace has great fireplace accessories, brass tool sets, elegant log baskets, even a solid brass butane fire lighter for $5.88, hearth rugs for $18.99. Warm up someone's holiday this Christmas with fireplace accessories from Ace.
How about that? All sorts of great stuff at participating Ace Hardware stores and home centers while supplies last. Hey, let me tell you, Ace is the place for me.
John, you can shop at Ace Hardware in Waynesboro late on Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. and Sunday afternoons from 1 o'clock till 6 o'clock.
The Wayne County High School Band. Here's what Congressman Don Sundquist had to say about it.
Oh, it's a wonderful band, and that's the kind of band that ought to play in the inaugural parade if we win. And I don't know if we can do it or not, but I'm sure going to recommend it.
Now the band needs that used instrument you have packed away someplace. The Wayne County Band Boosters can turn that used instrument into a tax-deductible donation for you. The band needs the instruments, and you need the tax deduction. So call Band Booster President Bobby Andrews at 722-3434 for more details, and thanks for your support. That's Bobby Andrews, 722-3434.
Well, you know, there's something right about this country when you can politic in squares and you have high school bands and, you know, it's autumn and you feel it. And we're lucky to live in this country. And we heard that music and saw all the people and it gave us a real lift, I'll tell you.
Well, the band is certainly sounded good this afternoon in Washington for the big inaugural parade, which will begin here, I guess, pretty soon, right?
That's right, Neil. The streets are lined with spectators. Looks like hundreds of thousands of them waiting for the parade to get underway.
Uh-huh.
Being entertained, of course, by 10 of these honor bands playing around the parade route.
Right.
Of which ours is one of them, in a very prominent location, I might say.
Well, I would think so. How far are you from the Capitol?
We can see the Capitol. The Capitol is right behind us. As a matter of fact, if you take a picture of this band, you can see the Capitol building. It's visible in the background. Of course, it's some distance away. We're actually closer to the White House than the Capitol, but the Capitol does make a visual backdrop for this band.
Uh-huh. Oh, that's nice. Gee, that's a great location, then, isn't it?
Nice. Couldn't be better.
Well, Dan, I'd like to mention again, the band has really sounded good today up there, and they're still sounding fine. The quality is just great, you know, all things considered with the breeze. You say it's kind of breezy up there now, right?
That's right. The wind is blowing very hard. The sun has come out now more, so that's started to warm things up a bit.
Yeah, we got sunshine down here, too, and it's a little breezy. And that makes it hard sometimes on the microphones when you're trying to pick up a band and where there's a bunch of them in it, like, you know, they are with the Waynesboro High School band there. There's so many in there. And the balance is it's just good, and we're enjoying it down here.
A lot of people around here are enjoying it, too.
Oh, I was...
Have you had a chance to get any response from the radio audience around Wayne County? How they've enjoyed it?
Oh, yes, we've had a lot of call. Dave's had a lot of call. He's been on the board, and all of us have been kind of sticking around, hanging around for it, you know. And then we've been out kind of making the rounds a little bit. Wayne and me made the rounds a few minutes ago, and then calls come in, and people, nice comments, real good comments. And they're really enjoying it, Dan.
Well, that's good.
Everybody is certainly enjoying it. Let me ask you what I'm thinking about. When will the band be coming back to Waynesboro?
The band will be back Sunday morning.
Bundred Car Care is now your Kerr McGee dealer for Wayne County, featuring Kerr McGee gas, diesel, and motor oil. To introduce you to these fine products, you get $5 worth of free gas when you complete your Kerr McGee credit application at Bundred's. Plus, the first 100 that use their Kerr McGee credit card for a gas fill-up get a free oil change at Bundred's. Bundred Car Care, Highway 64 East, Waynesboro. Your Kerr McGee dealer for Wayne County, and your Golf BP card is still good at Bundred Car Care. Cash drawings, December 23rd. They're giving away $100 at 5 o'clock, $25 at noon. And this Saturday, December 17th, they're giving away $50 at 5 o'clock and $25 at noon. You get $5 of free gas just for turning in your Kerr McGee credit application at Bundred Car Care. That's certainly worth doing. Bundred Car Care.
And I just work practically every show in the business.
Well, you must have really enjoyed that through the years.
Oh, I did. I loved it.
How would you compare the old-time radio with, say, television of today?
Well, an old-time radio was much easier because you read off a script.
I see. You didn't have to memorize it then.
Yeah, and... In television, you have to more or less memorize it.
They have idiot boards up for people that can't, you know, remember their lines. But as a rule, you had to, before they had the idiot boards, you had to memorize it perfectly so it would come out on time.
Mm-hmm. What about the effect of watching a comedy or a drama on television as compared to just listening to it on the radio?
Well, on radio, I was very fortunate in that I did so many voices. I could do 6 to 8 voices on a program, and they wouldn't know it was the same person.
Really?
But in television, they visualize everything that they hear and or see, and they see it and see what happens. Actually, you can't do more than 1 or 2 voices unless you do something off stage in a voice.
Now, when did you start doing this? Was it back in the 1930s?
Yes, I started in, I started in cartoons.
Oh, you started with cartoons?
No, I did radio first.
Radio first. Uh-huh.
And then I went into the cartoon business after trying for 1.5 years to get an audition with them.
Mm-hmm.
And I finally got an audition with them, and they had me do, the first voice I did with them was a drunken bull.
A drunken bull?
Yeah, they asked me if I could do a drunken bull. That was my first assignment.
Was that for Warner Brothers?
Yes.
Uh-huh. What does a drunken bull sound like, Mel?
Well, he sounds like he was a little louder than... He was looking for the... looking for the sour mash. That's a drunken bull.
Yeah, I can just picture that. Well, he'd be something in a china shop, wouldn't he?
Oh, yeah.
Now, you can actually do an entire Warner Brothers cartoon, can't you?
Yeah, that's right. I could do practically every voice in the business.
Bugs Bunny and...
Yeah, there's Bugs Bunny, you know, that's the one that talks with an accent, with a Brooklyn and Bronx accent.
Did you invent that voice?
Yes. They asked, they show me a picture of the character that's going to be in the cartoon. And then they show me a drawing of what he's going to do on what they call a storyboard. And from this, I have to create a voice. Well, they told me that Bugs was a tough little stinker, and I thought, which is the toughest voice in this country, either Brooklyn or the Bronx?
So I put the two of them together, Doc. That's how I got the voice for Bugs Bunny.
This is WTNR News, brought to you this hour by Wayne County Furniture. Voter registration office in Wayne County remains open until noon tomorrow. That's the last chance to register to vote in the general election next month. The Heart Walk starts at Wayne County High School tomorrow morning. Registration is at 9. The walk begins at 10. The Alternatives Fair is Saturday and Sunday at the farm in Summertown. Tour the largest passive solar heating building in the state. Learn about organic gardening, pest control, and more. Cost is $5. Take Highway 20 near Summertown, then Drake Lane. The United Methodist Youth, First Methodist Church in Waynesboro, has the annual fish fry tomorrow. Carry out 4:30 till 5, eat in from 5:30 on. Sunday is the circus in Waynesboro, the King Royal Brothers Circus, 3:30 p.m. One show only on the grounds at the National Guard Armory in Waynesboro, sponsored by Wayne County Chamber of Commerce. If you come early, you can see the large tent raising by elephants before the show. This is one of the last old-fashioned tented circuses. Advance tickets are still on sale at the Wayne County Chamber of Commerce, 722-9022. Linwood High School, Coach Danley says that Huntland is a real fine football team.
They've got everybody back from last year's squad. They're primarily a wishbone team, have good size, and they run the ball hard. They play tough defensively, so we've got our work cut out for us to get ready for them.
That's homecoming tonight at Collinwood High School. Wayne County High School travels to Hohenwald tonight. Coach Ferguson says the team has so many players injured.
We're probably going to have 5 starters that won't even train. It'll probably be at least another week before he gets to play. So we're really bunged up going into this Hohenwald game.
Concerning state politics, Democrat Calvin Moore and Republican Jim Hensley have both agreed to discuss the issues in the 70th District Legislative Race this Tuesday, October 6th. Right after the 9 o'clock CNN news, right here live on WTNR AM 930 and 94.9 FM. Dan Mullen, WTNR News, brought to you this hour by Wayne County Furniture. 2 trustee inmates from the South Central Correctional Center near Clifton have walked off the annex of the prison. Warden Joe Driscoll says they were counted at 6 a.m. this morning.